So that's actually fairly substantial. So in other words, if you start at one end of the cell and walk to the other end, you walked half a mile. Okay, so I alluded to this a second ago, but how would you increase the number of calls? In other words, you work for Rogers, and your boss calls you in his office and says, his iPhone is selling like hotcakes, and we're selling so many that we're jamming up our lines, we're jamming up our available bandwidth, and we need to expand the number of calls we can make in the city of Toronto. So how would we, let's think of a few ways to do that. Any suggestions? So I just said one. Microcells. So more generally, if this, so if there were specific areas where this was happening, I could shrink the size of cells locally. If this was happening all over the city, I could generally shrink the size of cells.
But all this does is mean that the bandwidth we use is getting closer together.
Yes. However,
which is not normally a problem.
It's not a problem because as long as you scale the power that the base station is transmitting at.
Right.
So basically, this boundary is defined by the amount of power the base station is using. So if that shrinks, then the size of the cell can shrink as well.
Does that narrowly mean that you need more base station then?
Yes. So that's a disadvantage. So the disadvantage here is cost. Yes. So you could have arbitrarily tiny cells. The problem would be that the cost per base station is fairly substantial. I mean, these are fairly powerful radios with lots of signal processing. There is also a certain overhead. We discussed this in terms of data networks. There's a certain overhead involved in handoffs. So if you're constantly moving from cell to cell, that could be a problem. So in other words, you don't want too many base stations. You want to have a nice happy medium between having enough bandwidth available for all your users and not having a network that's too expensive. Okay, can anyone think of another idea?
Get more bandwidth.
Okay, I have that under wrong answers. It sounds okay. The problem is getting more bandwidth is, for one thing, it's ludicrously expensive, and secondly, it's usually not available. So it's only available about once every decade or so.
So it's a good idea, but
it's a good idea, but not practical. That's right.
We're reducing the bandwidth that your phones use.
Okay, that's another interesting idea. I suggest that is probably not appropriate because it's appropriate only under the following circumstance. If you have advanced technology that allows you to maintain the same quality of service in a smaller band. So generally speaking, if you shrink the amount of bandwidth available, what will happen is your calls will lose quality. So your existing subscribers will be annoyed if in order to fit more of them in the same bandwidth, and they're presumably paying the same amount of money, their quality goes down. The question is, I guess, whether they would be equally annoyed if they can't make calls at all. But I think that's not necessarily an awesome idea. Now, I said technology, so modern digital cell phones use what are called vocoders, and basically what these do are they compress your voice to a very, very small number of bits by basically optimizing the compression with respect to the very sound that your voice makes. And these are getting better all the time. So it's possible that, yeah, you could do that with improved technology. There is one other thing that I have written down here. Yes?
GSM does time slot.
Time slot or frequency? So fundamentally, that's kind of the same thing because there's a trade-off between the number of
quality, yeah.
Yeah,
of course.
The number of bits you can pack into time in the band. What I've written down is reduce the reuse factor. So over here, we're reusing the same frequencies every 7 cells. We could reduce that to 4. If we reduce that to 4, the area per cluster would be 4 times 0.5, which is 2 kilometers squared. And then we would have 28 divided by 2, which is 14 clusters. So we'd be reusing the same frequency more often. What's the disadvantage there?
You'd have 14 clusters, but then you still only have 14 times 4, which is 6 cells.
We'd have 56
cells. The cells, we're assuming the cells are the same size.
Yeah,
cells would have more bandwidth, though.
That's right, the cells would have more bandwidth. So
I
multiplied 56 by, I erased it, but I multiplied it by the number of calls per cell. But that calls per cell is based on the reuse cluster size of 7, and that would increase. The disadvantage here, I think I heard someone say it, overlap, or more precisely, interference. In that case, the cells would tend to get closer together, and they would tend to interfere with each other. So we heard two interesting ideas that I suggest are not necessarily practical, and those are it would be impractical to increase the system bandwidth because I can guarantee you that every cellular provider that's out there is using all of the bandwidth that they have allocated to them because each and every hertz that they have is money to them.
And all those big auctions about bandwidth going to billions of dollars.
That's right. So that's right. So we just had it. There was a spectrum auction. I posted the link to the course website that happened not so long ago. And I can't remember how much it was, but the band, which was fairly narrow, I think it was on the order of 100 megahertz or so, went for billions of dollars. And that doesn't happen very often. So everyone is using all of their bandwidth usually. Or reduce bandwidth per call. So if you want to follow sort of the cellular principle, these are what you would do. You would shrink the cell size or change the reuse factor. Okay, so let's look at a couple of examples of that.